Hi, this is Luke from GuideMyJailbreak.com, and today I'm going to be showing you how to jailbreak your phone, iPad, or iPod Touch with Redsn0w. So if you're not already on our website, go ahead and go to GuideMyJailbreak.com for a complete guide to jailbreaking. Once you get there and you're watching this video, you're ready to start jailbreaking.
The key difference between this video and other videos I've done is that this jailbreak is tethered. And that's kind of unfortunate, but you can still jailbreak if you want to. A tethered jailbreak means that every time you reboot your device, meaning slide the power off and shut it down completely, you'll have to plug it into your computer to turn it back on. And you'll have to go through a certain amount of steps to turn it back on. So it's kind of annoying and, you know, no one really wants to do that. But if you really want to jailbreak, I mean, here's how you do it. It's not that difficult. And for most people, they don't really restart their device very much, so it's not a very big deal. But it's not an ideal situation to have to plug in your device every time you reboot. So let me go ahead and show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so say I had to turn my device off for some reason, or it just died. You would have to open up this app, click on Browse, find your firmware that you're about to download in this next step. Click on Next, wait a few seconds for it to load, click on Just Boot Tethered Right Now, and then Next. And then you'll have to hold on your power button for 3 seconds, and then hold on both buttons for 10 seconds, and then let go of your power button, and then hold on to that for 7 seconds. And then it'll boot right up. So it's not that difficult to do, but it's just kind of annoying. And don't worry, if you decide to do this, we have another video that just walks you through how to just boot tethered that just skips straight to the booting part, so you don't have to rewatch this video every time. Another good thing is that if you decide that you don't like it anymore after you jailbreak, you can always restore your device and go back to how it was before, and if you back up your device, then it'll all be the same as it is right now. And just to help you out, we have another video in our FAQ section at the top of this website that teaches you how to do that. So just to review, if you wanted to jailbreak tethered jailbreak, after you jailbreak, every time you restarted, you'd have to plug into your computer. Jailbreaking adds tons and tons of functionality, so I think it's definitely worth it, but it's up to you. So if you want to jailbreak, keep on watching. Your first step is to download Redsn0w for your Mac. So click on the link below and download Redsn0w. Okay, great, so you downloaded Redsn0w. Now it's time to open it, so go ahead and click on it, and then open the file that you downloaded it to. In my case, I went to my downloads folder. Go ahead and double click on it, and then double click on Redsn0w. Okay, so on Windows, your first step is to download Redsn0w. So go ahead and click on Redsn0w for Windows, click on Open, double click on the folder, and then double click on Redsn0w. Click run again, and now you're there. So now you'll see this window, and it just says, you know, copyright information, and then to read all the accompanying text. You can move that over for now. The next thing you'll need to do is download the firmware for your specific device. For example, I'm using an iPod Touch 4G 4.3.3, but if you followed through with this guide from the beginning, from GuideMyJailbreak.com, then at the top of the screen, it should say the firmware you have. So go ahead and click on Firmware Download Link, and it'll download to your computer. This will take some time, so come back when it's done. Hopefully that downloaded to your computer. So now it's time to jailbreak. So go ahead and open up that Redsn0w application you opened up earlier. Click on Browse, and find that file. So for me, I went to my Home folder, and then my Downloads folder, and then you need to click on that file, and then click Open. So that'll load it into the application, and then you need to click Next, and then it'll take a few seconds to load. Your next step is to make sure that Install Cydia is checked. Whether you have an iPhone or iPod Touch or iPad, those other checkboxes will be different, but just make sure Install Cydia is checked. Then you can click Next. Okay, so this next part is where it gets a little bit tricky. Your next step is to plug in your device and then turn it off completely. So to do that, go ahead and just click and hold the sleep button for about 5 seconds, and then slide to power off. Okay, for this next part, you might want to watch before you actually do it. What you'll need to do is immediately hold on the sleep button for 3 seconds, then, while you're holding onto the sleep button, hold on to the home button for 10 seconds, and then let go of the sleep button. After you do this, you're done. So go ahead and watch this before you do it. And don't worry, if you mess up the first time, you can always try again.
Okay, so while that jailbreaks, I'm just going to speed it up. So this is just jailbreaking your phone, moving applications, things like that. So just wait for that to finish. That could take up to 5 minutes. And when that's done, watch the rest. Okay, so now that's finished, your device should restart, and you should see the Apple logo. So wait for your device to boot up, and you'll be ready to go. Okay, so once your device finishes rebooting, just slide to unlock, and then you should try to find an app called Cydia that's been added to your device. As you can see, nothing's changed, just a new app called Cydia. Okay, so now that you've jailbroken successfully, now you need to learn how to turn on your device if it does turn off, or if you need to reboot it. So to do that, go ahead and open up that Redsn0w application again, click Browse, click on that firmware you downloaded earlier, click Open, click Next, wait for it to load. This is all the same thing that you just did. And instead of doing Install Cydia, choose Just Boot Tether Right Now, click Next, and then when you click Next, you're going to do the same exact motion you just did, hold on the power button for 3 seconds, without releasing the power button, hold on both for 10 seconds. And then release the power button for 7 seconds. This is all the same thing you just did. And if you mess up, don't worry, you can try again. And soon you'll be able to do it without even using the video. If you have any issues at all, make sure to ask for help. So at the top of this website, there's a button that says Ask for Help. You can click on that and go right in and ask a question and someone will answer very quickly. So congratulations on successfully jailbreaking your device. If you're ready to embark on making your device so much better, go ahead and click on the Learn Cydia button below. Thanks for watching.